preface to Fighter Pilot wrote that there is only one witness to life. That is the person who lived it. No one else will ever know. Ed said he never wanted to have any regrets in life, and so he lived life to its fullest. He even had a rabbi at his funeral, but he wasn't Jewish. Ed gave his all for the sake of a country that is beloved as a second Jerusalem, and it is my distinct honor to be here to share just a hint of Ed's life about a man who is great and who lived a remarkable life. Ed was 23 years old when he, 1965, when he graduated from pilot training. Flying had been Ed's dream ever since he was a little kid. Ever since in seventh grade in Chicago, he finished in the top 10 out of 350 graduates and won first choice of aircraft assignments, one of 9 slots for the F-105 Thunder Chief. As a pilot in the Vietnam War, Ed volunteered for 2 tours of combat duty, 1966 and the 1972 tour, and flew more than 250 combat missions in the fastest jets of the time, the F-105 Thunder Chief and the F-4 Phantom. In the process, he earned the Silver Star, the Distinguished Flying Cross 5 times, as well as the Air Medal with 19 oak leaf clusters and an array of battle ribbons and awards. He was a graduate of Chicago's Illinois Institute of Technology with a degree in political science, as well as a master's degree in political science from Auburn University and a master's in international relations from Troy State. Since leaving the Air Force, Ed worked for a major aerospace contractor in the development of next generation tactical aircraft, as well as wrote extensively for computer magazines and had a weekly column in several publications and hundreds of software reviews. Ed taught political science in Colorado for several years and spoke on the Vietnam Air War at the Air Force Academy, the National Museum of the Air Force, as well as many colleges and libraries and throughout the country. He was a person who was an in-demand speaker. He continued to write and research on the history of the incorporation of women into the tactical flying and fighting profession. Ed was the author of 3 best-selling books, books that were must-reads and continue to be must-reads in the fighter pilot world. They were When Thunder Rolled, Palace Cobra, those 2 books about his own personal experiences in Vietnam, and Fighter Pilot, the memoirs of legendary ace Robin Olds. Now, a little bit for the rest of the story. Carol called Ed Mr. Google because he was so smart. He had all the answers, even in her field, speech-language pathology, which he has been a highly paid expert in for decades. He loved his wife dearly. They were together for 40 years. When I asked Carol how they met, she said, "Oh, that's a story we can't repeat." But I can share, they met in a bar in Madrid. And the romance continued for decades thereafter. She was attracted to his good looks, his verbal ability, his cockiness. I can add this Jewish part, he had chutzpah. And that he was so coordinated, but not in the house. When I asked Carol, wait, what do you mean by that? She said, whenever anything broke in the house, Ed would say, "Get the checkbook." If a light bulb needed changing, he would say, "That's the crew chief's job." Let's just say, in the words of Annette, he was a city person. After his military career, he was also an expert in computers, guns, the Constitution, and scotch. He loved their very close friends, including Annette, who was like a daughter to him, and her late husband, Vince, who he would go hunting with often, You love Dave Brogue, who knew that he could be depended on to help Carol through the ordeal of setting up this funeral. He also loved his country. He joined the Air Force because of his love of flying, but taking the oath of office to defend this nation against all enemies, foreign and domestic, so help me God, were not words he took casually. Those were words he took to heart. Ed was a man of keen and incisive intellect, fired with enthusiasm, always positive. He only knew how to do his very best in everything he undertook. To paraphrase Robin Olds, Brigadier General retired, you must be proud and grateful that your nation produces men like these. I say, yes, we are very proud and grateful that our nation produced Ed Razumus. May his soul rest. Oh, I have slipped the surly bonds of earth and danced the skies on laughter's silver wings. Sunward I've climbed and joined the tumbling mirth of sun-split clouds and done 100 things you have not dreamed of. Wheeled and soared and swung high in the sunlit seas, hovering there, I've chased the shouting wind along and flung my eager craft through footless halls of air. Up, up the long, delirious, burning blue, I've topped the windswept heights with easy grace. When never lark or even eagle flew, and while with silent lifting mind I've trod the high untrespassed sanctity of space, put my hand and touched the face of God. May God bless Ed and Carol. We pray for Ed on his final flight west and
up the pipes are calling. From glen to glen and down the mountainside, the summer's gone and all of the roses falling. 'Tis you, 'tis you must go, and I must bide. But come ye back when summer's in the meadow, or when the valley's hushed and white with snow. Is I'll be here in the sunshine or in shadow. Oh, Danny boy, oh, Danny boy, we love you so. And when he comes, all of the flowers are dying, and I am dead as dead I well may be. You'll come and find the place where I am lying, and kneel and say an Ave there for me. And I shall hear and on my grave will a warmer sleep. They stand and they stare at the bloody great hair of Olivia.